Shalom. First and foremost, I'm going to give all honor and glory to Yahweh by Hashem, Yahweh Shai by Hashem, Rekha Kadash, double honors to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone, Rule Web, and the greatest amputation, younger brothers in the truth, and peace and blessing to the hopeful elect. And it reads, and except those days should be shortened, there should no flesh be saved, but for the elect's sake, those days shall be shortened. And I'm going to go into the little video where I brought that out. And this guy, you know, the Yahshua put this up on his 2thRuinInfo page. On his 2thRuinInfo page, and he put up Habakkuk 2:17, the spoil of beasts. You know, that's the title of the video. This just a little short, so let's get into it.
Don't sin, oh, I'm no good for you. I've learned to lose, you can't afford to. Torn my shirt to stop you bleeding. But nothing ever stops you leaving.
Destroying the planet, man, because this is up under his rulership. This not up under the rulership of no other nation but Esau, Edom. Like the scriptures say in Job 9:24, the earth was given into the hands of the wicked. He covered the face of the judges thereof. Is not weird, then who is he? This man is the only man who covered the faces of the judges, and the ultimate judge is Yahweh Shai. The ultimate judge is Yahweh. And Yahweh gave all judgment to
you. If you look up an image of the Lord and his only begotten son, they gonna be white. You know, a prime example is that Renaissance art painting with supposed to been Adam. I think it was Adam and supposedly the Lord, and they touching fingers. I forgot the name of the painting right now. You know. That's a prime example. You know, but they go to show you that this man is that wicked, you know. Then shall that wicked be revealed, the son of perdition. The man of sin, it ain't say then shall the, not the wicked, but then shall the man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition. And Esau, Edom is the son of perdition, the man of sin, you know. Who is being revealed now? You know, we see this guy, you know, we done labeled him. We gave him his true label. He's not a white man. You know, he's not a European, French, you know, Briton. No, this nigga is an Edomite, man. You know, the nigga all over the earth. I'm Australian. No, you're an Edomite, man. You know? And we found you out, and you're destroying the earth. Matter of fact, I think this... Let's see, I think Revelation 11 and 18, I think it says something like that in the Revelation 11 and 18. Let's go to Revelation 11. This Revelation 11, yep, in verse 18, it say, and the nations were angry, and the wrath is come, and the time of the dead, that they should be judged, and that thou shouldest give reward unto thy servants, the prophets, and to the saints, which are the elect of the nation of Israel, and to them that fear thy name, small and great. So you got to know the name to fear the name. You can't fear the name if you don't know it. and to them that fear thy name, small and great, and should have destroyed them which destroyed the earth. Yeah. And Esau, Edom is the top nation. Well, Esau, Edom is running the earth. So if you got power over all the earth, if things are going wrong, it's your fault, man. You know, you are the one who's supposed to be there to, you know, put your foot down. No, you can't keep. You're the manager, so to speak. You in charge. That's like a restaurant. If a restaurant is, you know, roaches and rats, you know, and the manager ain't doing nothing about it, you know. When the store owner come and see the problem, you know, bread old, you know, food fucked up, poor customer service, and you know, when the store owner come up, the manager gonna be in trouble. Esau is the manager of the earth right now, you know, and he under him the earth is being defiled, man, destroyed. You know, the animals, those were extinct animals. The elephants and the leopards and, you know, they damn near extinct fucking with Esau, man. You know, you can count some of them with your fingers, man, how many left. In which we know the Lord gonna bring all these things back in their fullness. So, you know, it's a scripture, roughly paraphrasing, there's no end to the Lord's creation, roughly paraphrasing. So, Lord gonna bring these things back to animals, and, you know, these things are gonna be in the kingdom of heaven, man. Lord gonna beautify the kingdom. Lord gonna bring these things back, which, you know, the earth is so big and plenteous, the Lord may have these animals on the head from Esau, so he can't find them and destroy them up. Oh, and even if not, the Lord can bring those animals back and some that you never seen before, you know. So let's keep going. This Habakkuk 2, the title of the lesson, Habakkuk 2, and I'm gonna start down. Trying to see where I'm gonna start. I guess I start at 12. This Revelation chapter 2 and verse 12, it say, woe unto him that buildeth a town on blood and establisheth a city by iniquity. Behold, is it not of the Lord of hosts that the people shall labor in the very fire, and the people shall be weary themselves in very vanity? It say, for the earth shall be filled with the knowledge of the glory of the Lord, as the waters covereth the sea. Woe unto him that giveth his neighbor drink, that putteth thy bottle to him that maketh him drunken. Also, that thou mayest look on their nakedness, thou art filled with shame for glory. Drink thou also, and let thy foreskin be uncovered. The cup of the Lord's right hand shall be turned unto thee, and shameful spewing shall be on thy glory. Going to Esau, Edom, so-called white man. That's what we're talking about. You know, he the one give his neighbor to drink, make him drunk. You know, but the Lord is uncovering this man. Verse 17, it say, for the violence of Lebanon shall cover thee, and the spoil of beasts which made them afraid because of men's blood, for the violence of the land, of the city, and of all that dwell therein. It say, what profit the graven image that the maker thereof have given it, the molten image, and a teacher of lies, Esau, Edom. He was a liar and the father of lies. He taught the whole earth a lie, you know. You know, and they continue to push and make their own lies and just people through, man. That the maker of his work trusteth therein to make dumb idols. Yeah, and these people through, man. It say, woe unto him that sitteth to the wood, awake, and to the dumb stone, arise. It shall teach. Behold, it is laid over with gold and silver, and there is no breath at all in the midst of it. It say, but the Lord is in his holy temple. Which temple ye are, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, and those who woke up to this knowledge, wisdom, and understanding, first and foremost. Let all the earth keep silence before him. You know, so the Lord, it say, but the Lord is in his holy temple. The Lord is in the midst of the elect of the nation of Israel. We pray we are part of that number, man. The Lord is here. The Lord is with this men. The Lord is, you know, hey, the Lord is here, man. The knowledge, wisdom, understanding is here. Of the Lord. His name is here. You know, so we got something to call upon. You know, the angels, they're here. We can't see them, but they're here. You know? They reveal themselves when they want to. This the book of Hosea, chapter. This the last precept. I'm going to close it out with this. This the book of Hosea, chapter 4 and verse 1. It reads, hear the word of the Lord, ye children of Israel. Now, that's speaking to the children of Israel, but Esau picked this book up that don't belong to him. So he finna be judged with this book, man. You know, harshly. It say, for the Lord have a controversy with the inhabitants of the land, because there is no truth, nor mercy, nor knowledge of Yahweh in the land. Yeah, and that's how it was for a long time until the Lord start waking up his men. You know, it wasn't no truth knowledge. It wasn't no truth nor mercy nor knowledge of the Lord in the land. And when we speak about the land, we're talking about the whole earth, man. It wasn't nothing in the earth. It say, therefore shall the land mourn, and everyone that dwell therein shall languish with the beast of the field and with the fowls of heaven. Yeah, the fish of the sea also shall be taken away. And that's what's going on, man. Everything is languishing. Matter of fact, let's look up that word, languish. You know, that's pretty much the point. I wasn't trying to make it a long lesson. I supposed to been did this video, so it's a lock in, you know. I've been slacking. I got to get back on it, man. Got to change my diet and... You know, really need to go on the cleanse myself out so I can think and it can flow, the spirit can flow better. It's a language of a person or other living thing, lose or lacking vitality, grow weak or feeble, suffer being forced to remain in an unpleasant place or situation. Yeah, that's why the animals... You know, water defiled, the air defiled, animals dropping dead. You know, when you in a weak, or you weak and feeble, you vulnerable, you liable to drop dead, man. You know?
Feel like I'm trying to pull that word up.
But that's pretty much the point, you know. Matter of fact, let's just try to look it up.
Languish. I don't know how to spell, so it's like it.
Yep. Yep. And this one at the bottom, the second one, it say suffer or being forced to remain in an unpleasant place or situation. It's in one of the words, the similar words, waste away, rot, decay, wither away, be abandoned, be neglected, be forgotten, suffer, to be disregarded, experience hardship. And that's what the animals are going through, you know. Fade, fail, waste away. The point is wasting away. When you waste away, you being put, you being killed off, man. That's why I started with, except the Lord has shortened the days, there shall no flesh be saved. Not only for the animals, but for the people as well, man. It's Esau fucking some shit up, man. Let's get this Proverbs 29. And we close out with it. Because not only the animals, but the people as well, man. You know, Esau's agenda is to destroy majority of the people in the earth. Perfect balance with nature. This Proverbs 29:2, it say, when the righteous are in authority, the people rejoice. Not only the people, the animals, and everything else as well. But when the wicked bear rule, the people mourn. So let's try to find that one precept too. Let's try to find it too. The fir tree. Because the whole existence is waiting on Esau to fall. This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 14 and verse 8. Straight to the point, it say, yeah, the fir trees rejoice at thee, and the cedars of Lebanon, saying, since thou art laid down, no feller is come up against us. You know, and even the trees, the plants, everything is going to rejoice. There ain't going to be no pesticides and herbicides in the kingdom, man. Ain't going to be no deforestation in the kingdom, man. Nah, that ain't gonna happen in the kingdom. Oh, I'm going to sleep. Let's go here. This the book of Romans, chapter. This the book of Romans, chapter 8 and verse 22. Let me pull up the whole thing. Romans chapter 8 and verse 18. It say, for I reckon that the suffering of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us. For the earnest expectation of the creature, a creature is something created, waiteth for the manifestation of the sons of God, which are the so-called Negro, Latinos, and Native American, the Hebrew Israelites. Those are the sons of God. It say, for the creature was made subject to vanity, not willingly, but by reason of him who has subjected him, who have subjected the same to hope, in hope, to same in hope, because the creature itself also shall be delivered from the bondage of corruption unto the glorious liberty of the children of Yahweh. It say, for we know that the whole creation, everything, man, that's the point, because we are that creature made subject to vanity, cast into those chains of darkness. You know, we that creature made subject to vanity. Then it say right here, verse 22, it say, for we know the whole creation, everything, man, groaneth and travail and pain together until now. Languish. Everything is languishing. You know? Until now. And not only they, but ourselves also, which have the first fruits of the Spirit. Lord willing, we that number. That first fruits of the Spirit is the 144,000, man. The first spirits created. You know? After Yahweh Shai. That 144,000. It say, even we ourselves groan within ourselves, waiting for the adoption to with the redemption of our body. For we are saved by hope, but hope that is seen is not hope. Yeah, so we got faith, man. Hope that is seen is not hope. If you can see it, you ain't got nothing to hope in, man. For what man seeth, why doeth he yet hope? Yeah, because if you see it, why you hoping for it? You see it. But we hope for that we see not. Then do we wait patient. Then do we patient wait for it. Yeah, and that's what we doing, man. We patiently waiting for the things that are promised to us. But that's pretty much the point. Lord, when this will edify, I want to end the giving all honor and glory to Yahweh by Hashem, Yahweh Shai by Hashem, Kakadash. And once again, double honors to our apostles and elders, a great millstone, rule well, been a great example to us, younger brothers in the truth, and peace and blessing to the hopeful elect. Shalom, Kormi Yasha Allah, Baba, Shalom.